Hello everybody. Won't you join me in a few yogic movements today? I'm just getting my day started, so I would like to actually start in table position. And before I do a few rounds of cat-cows, I'm going to do a few neck and head movements just to get me going. I'll do full rotation in each direction. And then what I'm going to do is kind of shift my hips from side to side. And then I'm actually going to move forward and back. I'm not doing full extension yet. I'm just trying to get some body movement going. Coming up on my fingertips. Loosening to the fingers. Getting ready to position myself. I got the starfish fingers spread for the energy. One more time from side to side. And then I'm actually going to do a full rotation. So I'm going to come all the way around and back. All the way around. And then I'm going to reverse. I'm going to come back to center. And here is where I'm going to do the cat-cows. Arching the back. Curling the back. Arching. Curling. I'm going to do a few more rounds. I'm going to return to neutral spine. And now from here, I am going to fall all the way back. And then come all the way forward. I'm going to do these a few rounds. Again, I'm just getting my day started so I can feel a bit of tension in the body. And this is helping to loosen everything up. Do a couple more rounds. When I come back this time, I'm going to splay my legs a little wider, my knees apart, and go into my child's pose. Take an opportunity to wiggle the fingers and rotate the wrist. Open and close the fist. Loosen up any tension that may have garnered in that area. When I come out of child's pose, I'm going to come halfway here to my forearms. Taking a little crouch here, a little crouch. I'm going to come up. Come into my cobra. And kind of hold here. You can also come down. Go to your forearms. You move back a little bit here. Sphinx, I believe. I'm gonna come flat. Lay my head to one side. Pick a side, doesn't matter which side. Palms are facing up or down if you're comfortable with that. I'm gonna face up as if to release energy
into the atmosphere. Raising one leg. I'm not only going to rotate the ankle, scrunch the toes, but I'm also going to rotate the foot, the leg, working into the knee joint. A little movement there. And I'm going to release it down to the floor. Rotate my head to the other direction. Come up. Rotate the ankles, scrunch the toes, move the foot, rotate the full leg, bring it back down. Just for fun, I'm going to bring them both up, splay them from side to side. Like windshield wipers. Bring them back to the center, lower them down. Bring my hands back under my shoulders, next to my body. Bring myself up, back to tabletop position. Do a little balancing here, a little spinal balance, but before I do that, I'm actually gonna do a spinal twist. So I'm going to center one hand and then raise the other up. And I'm actually going to feed it through the needle. Put the shoulder down to the floor. You can bring your hand behind your back. Come out of it, bring it all the way back up, and then release it down. Repeat that on the other side. Center the hand, bring the arm up, feed it through the needle, thread the needle, shoulder down. Adjust where you're comfortable with your other hand. And also put it behind your back. Back up. Bring it all the way up, fingertips to the ceiling or the sky. And then release back down. And at any point, if you feel like you want to shift your hips from side to side, or if you want to go into a full rotation or half rotation, feel free to do that at any time. If you feel you're getting tension in your wrist, feel free to do that. Now I'm going to extend. I'm doing my left. It doesn't matter which leg. The object is to be balanced, so we will do both sides. So, I'm going to extend one leg back. I'm kind of giving it a stretch right now. It's still planted to the floor. And then I'm going to raise it up. Toes pointed down to the floor. Now, when we go into spinal balance or a bird dog, I'm going to now extend the opposite arm, reaching long. Fingertips reaching, palm facing to your opposite side. And basically, I'm holding my balance here, spinal balance. Finding your spot, your sweet spot, if you will. Don't worry if you sway or tremor. It's your body making its adjustments. Embrace it. And if you feel so inclined for a little bit of ab work, crunch and hold and relief. Crunch and hold. Release. Crunch, hold. Release and hold. Releasing the hand, followed by the foot, keeping the foot on the floor but turning it sideways. And then we're going to do a little bit of side balance here.
You can leave your foot on the ground or do some things a little more challenging, like lifting it, letting it hover, bringing your arm forward. Bringing it back down, releasing the arm, releasing the knee. You want to take a moment in child's pose. You can feel free to do that. And when we return to table, extend your opposite leg. In my case, it's my right leg. I'm pressing into the ball of the foot, giving my toes a good stretch here, giving my hamstring a good stretch too, extending the leg. Then I'm gonna raise it off the floor, let it hover, toes pointing down, trying to keep your hips even. Then I'm extending the opposite arm, which really should just float freely up. Once you find that sweet spot where you're pretty evenly balanced and you can hold position comfortably, you're gonna sway, rock, maybe tremor. It's okay, embrace it. Then we're gonna pull in and then out for a little bit of ab work here. Pull in and then out. Pull in and out. I'm gonna do one more. In and out and hold. Release the hand, release the foot, lay it down. Cross the arch sideways, raise the arm, side spinal balance here. And if you're so inclined to do so, allow that leg to come off the floor and hover. Allow that arm to reach an opposite direction. Working your balance here, challenging your body. Returning back into position. Again, you can go back into child's pose if you need a break. Return to tabletop. And I'm actually going to bring my feet in, sit back on my legs. And I'm going to end out that little yogic session, because time, you lose track of time when you're doing your yoga. So I don't want to have a super long video. Each time I do a video, it'll be something a little bit different than the last time. So it'll be a build up, and you guys can pick and choose from each video segment what you want to put together, what you want to take from it, what you want to leave. It's up to you. So on that note, I'm gonna bid you guys adieu. See you next time.